Hi, my name is Rachel, and I study biogeochemistry, which is a scary word, but in my case, it just means that I study how bacteria, bio, affects rock formation, geo, and composition, chemistry. In this talk, I'm going to be discussing the place where my research occurs. I often have friends or students tell me that they didn't know that organisms could live without oxygen. And this is understandable because we as humans need oxygen to live. But this means that many people are unaware of the vast array of organisms that don't require oxygen to live, and that this diversity has allowed many organisms to inhabit what would be extremely hostile environments to humans. Which brings me to the place where my research occurs. It's an environment rather than a location. Euxinic environments. These are aquatic environments where oxygen is absent and sulfide is abundant. And the microbes that live in this environment not only tolerate it, but also maintain it. They eat sulfate and produce sulfide. These are the bacteria that I study. Where can we find euxinic environments? Well, these bacteria hate oxygen, so they only live in the deep, dark corners of the ocean today where oxygen is absent, such as the Black Sea, as shown in this picture. However, on early Earth, before oxygen-producing organisms caused oxygen content on Earth to rise, euxinic environments were all the rage. But how do we go back in time to study this oxygen-free period on Earth? Well, before I tell you the how and the what of my research, allow me to tell you the why, because you might be wondering, why do we study Earth's past to begin with? So there are many reasons why this research is important, but here I list two that I consider the most significant and exciting. First, climate. How do we predict future climate trends? We can't take future measurements, so we have to take past measurements. And the further back our data goes, the better our predictions become. So how do we know the environmental conditions from before humans were around to measure them? Rocks. Rocks preserve chemical, biological, and physical signatures that tell us the environment in which they formed. The second why on this list is astrobiology, which is exactly what it sounds like, biology in space. And I'm not saying that we've already found evidence for biology in space, but studying astrobiology can help us get there. And because many potentially inhabited planets and moons have oceans and negligible oxygen, euxinic environments on Earth are the perfect analogs to studying these extraterrestrial environments in which we might find life. Great, so we've established that this research is important, but how do we study these environments, and what is it that I'm looking for when I analyze the chemistry of these rocks or lab-synthesized precipitates? I look for trace metal signatures, because the amount and type of trace metals in a particular rock can tell us whether that rock formed in an euxinic environment or not. And if we do this with enough rocks from enough locations and enough times throughout Earth's history, we can create a pretty clear picture of how euxinic environments have evolved on our planet. The last thing I want to emphasize is how lucky I am that my research allows me to study a place that is found not only on modern Earth and ancient Earth, but likely even extraterrestrial worlds. Thanks for watching.